Hi everybody, this is Dr. A, and in this video on quality, we are going to talk about diagnostic efficiency. Okay, so first let's start with diagnostic efficiency parameters. So the prevalence of a disease is a proportion of a population who have the disease. The incidence of a disease is the number of persons found to have the disease within a defined period, such as a year, in a population of 100,000. So it could be an incidence of 6.5 per 100,000 or something like that. The parameters that are used to determine how good a given test is at detecting and predicting the presence of disease are things like sensitivity and specificity, and we're going to also look at positive and negative predictive values. So let's start with sensitivity. So there are two types of sensitivity, often referred to in the lab. There's analytical and clinical. And so analytic sensitivity is the lower limit of detection for a given analyte. So can it detect it down to zero or down to 0.5 or 10 or something like that? And then what happens is if let's say it detects down to 10 of whatever units, then anything below that would have to be reported as less than 10 units for that given analyte. For clinical sensitivity, the definition is it's the proportion of people with a disease who test positive with a test that is screening for that disease. The specificity is a proportion of individuals without a condition who have a negative test for that condition. So when we look at that and when we do studies, we test people that have the disease and that don't have the disease against a test and to see the results that we get, and then we qualify these results. And so they are true positive, true negatives, false positive, and false negatives. So true positives are the patients who have a positive test results and who also have the disease or condition in question. The true negatives are those who have a negative test result and who do not have the disease or condition. The false positives are those patients who have a positive test result, but they do not have the disease. And the false negatives are those who have a negative test result, but do have the disease. Okay, so then from that we can calculate predictive value, as in positive predictive value, negative predictive value, and then we can calculate diagnostic sensitivity and diagnostic specificity. So the positive predictive value is the chance of an individual having the condition if the test is abnormal. So it equals to the number of patients with an abnormal test result who have the disease divided by the total number of patients with an abnormal result. It can also equal, if you will, the number of true positives divided by the sum of the true positives and the false positives. Okay, so that gives you the positive predictive value. The negative predictive value is the chance of an individual not having the condition if the test is normal. It equals the number of patients with a normal test results who do not have the disease divided by the total number of patients with a normal or negative result. So that would be the true negatives divided by the true negatives plus the false negatives. The diagnostic sensitivity of a test is the ability to detect a condition. It is the true positives divided by the true positive plus the false negatives, or the number of subjects with a condition with a positive test divided by the number of subjects with the condition. The diagnostic specificity of a test is the ability of a test to correctly identify a person without the condition. And it's basically the number of subjects without a condition with a negative test that are divided by the number of subjects without the condition. So it's the true negatives divided by the true negatives plus the false positives. And all of those are going to be expressed in percentages. So a test could have a diagnostic sensitivity of 98% and a specificity of 95% or something like that. And so those are reported as part of the test, as part of the methods, and or part of the kits if you buy a kit. And they can help a lab decide which kit to purchase or which methodology to go with. And then there is also a measure of diagnostic efficiency. So it depends entirely on the distribution of test results for a population with and without the condition, and the cutoff used to determine or to define abnormal levels. So to define an appropriate cutoff, they use a graphical tool that's called the Receiver Operator Characteristic, or ROC. And ROC curves are generated by plotting the true positive rate against a false positive rate. So it's actually sensitivity versus specificity. And it can be used to find the most efficient cutoff for a test. And the area under the curve will represent the efficiency of the test or how many people were correctly classified. And that's correctly classified as either having or not having the disease. The higher the area under the curve, then the greater the efficiency of the diagnostic test. So, all right, so that wraps up diagnostic efficiency, and there'll be more videos on quality, but we're going to move into quality assurance now, and so I will see you there.